training with him, getting his confidence.
He's going to make one hell of a horse. All his fears left him now. He has far more confidence in himself, courage in what you want him to do. You'll see as we go on what we achieve with him over. Please, please, please consider this before you set off and break your own horse. And I'm not saying this because we're looking for work. We're stacked out with work. Oh, baby, good boy. What you got to look at is this fella. These horses, these are dumb animals. Have you got the skill to break the horse and make him safe, confident, and happy in any sphere of harness work? That's what we aim to do here. If you look at our films on YouTube, there's hundreds on there. People keep saying to me, why don't you make a film? Why don't you make a film from start to finish of what you do? Because every horse is an individual. What works for one would be the worst possible thing to do with another horse. People are asking me all the time, make a film. They've made bloody books. Anyone that's ever wrote a book didn't tell you what to do when it goes wrong. And that's the problem. And the only one that suffers is him. The horse is the one that suffers. The pony, the horse or whatever suffers. Because man is not up to the task. The next thing people say to me is, I've bought a cheap bit of that Indian harness or a foreign harness just to get him going. Well, that's some brains, isn't it? That's the most stupidest thing you could do. The very time when you want a good set of harness, strong, safe set of harness, people go and find the cheapest rubbish they can. They put them in an old made-up two-wheeler. You know, it's no good. You owe it to this horse first and foremost. If you want to kill yourself, that's lovely. But you ain't got the tyre tied to you. You ain't got the pallet like I see someone do the other day with a pallet, a wooden pallet behind the horse, which is put together with nails and God knows what, behind the horse, pulling it. He's pulled a pallet up the road. Well, yippee yippee. That's marvellous when that comes smashing up behind him. A tyre's bad enough. Look at that big metal swingle tree on there we're using. You know, you've got to know what you're doing, and we owe it to these horses. Dear God in heaven, they'd lay their life down for you. They'd work until they fell down on their knees. They'd do anything for you. They're beautiful, beautiful animals. And all they want is a bit of kindness, a bit of time, a bit of love, and a bit of discipline. Yeah, and this, to my mind, is a partnership. But you cannot break horses to what's written down in a book. It will work with some horses, but when it goes wrong, we don't hear of them horses. They end up in an auction or sold as riders or sold. We've had some here that have been sold to people. As soon as I put the harness on, I know they've had harness on before. And you can see that they've run away, they're frightened, they're terrified, they're shaking. When you put it on, no good. This horse, when we went to start doing anything with him, you know, like just started into duty, he was frightened. Make no mistake about it, he was frightened, he didn't want to know. But he's come back, and I think he's going to make one hell of a good cob, a real good cob. A lovely, lovely, lovely boy. But when people say to me, tell us how you do it. There's nothing I do. I don't whisper in his ear at 3 o'clock on a Wednesday morning and all of a sudden the horse is a wonderful horse. It's a lot of bloody hard work. It's a lot of know-how. And you can't write a book about it. We'll help anybody we can. If you're going to break your own horse, make sure you know what you're doing. You owe it to the horse. Make sure you know what you're doing. Don't let your horse be one that ends up in a market because it's run away with something behind it. You put it in the shafts for the first time and it goes absolutely crackers. We haven't got the right to do that to horses. We've got to show them the respect they deserve. That's why we drive in rubber bits. That's the reason we do it. You'll see this horse across the road doing exactly what he's done now in a rubber bit. Right, I've just done it in head collar over here, not because I've enclosed, I just took him out on the road. I know what I'm doing. I'm sorry if I've rambled on, and I'm sorry if I'm passionate and get uptight. But I love my horses, with all my heart and soul I love them. And we owe it to them, if we're going to do this, is break them right, school them right. You know, natural horsemanship right, whatever you want to say it is, do it right for these horses.
All right, mate. You lovely old boy. Good boy.
Just go and draw that out, write that down. Get him to pull them beams out. Let's get a measurement on them, see we're right. There you go.
I'll go off around the field, or do you want me just on the straight?